talk about transformation, make sure that it is sustainable. And the early parts of the transformation involve a number of initiatives in the form of our IT platform, people, processes as well. There's greater accountability and there's a better execution. As you focus on your fundamentals, your profit improves, your customer service improves, that's when you know, people will be happy with your services, they'll keep coming back to you and will be doing more business, and that will result in more gain profits, and eventually your share price will actually improve.
I've seen the growth of Maybank from so-called a coffee shop bank to what it is today. We are very proud of our achievement today.
Online banking, because I use it almost every day and it's very, very convenient because I can be at any point or any part of the world and I can still use it.
Focus on three areas of customer service. Our average waiting time for the queue, turnaround time for the loans, both business banking and our retail loan, especially the mortgage. Third area is on our not product knowledge.
Our staff now are more trained in dealing with customers, providing the customers with the best pleasurable experience when they visit the branch. We are more trained to deliver the correct attitude towards our clients.
I find it very convenient in every state or every city that Maybank is available to get money or to do some transaction through the Maybank.
Looking at the Malaysian insurance and Takaful market and the tremendous potential that we have with our distribution partners, Etiqa should be able to reach 1 billion profit before tax by 2015. Etiqa is the preferred brand for all Malaysians everywhere. Strategy focus will be implementation and turning humanizing into a true customer experience.
2011 was really on our five core systems, MTU, MTE, ATMs, credit cards and core, was making sure that we are serving customers better.
The engagement with the client has gotten a lot more proactive and a lot more intense. GWB differences in the way we interact with our clients. The engagement with clients now would involve people from various businesses in the group. For banking as a way to win other businesses as well.
We manage funds for insurance companies, pension funds, charities, and Maybank Custodial Services have been our custodians for a number of those clients. The experience has been good.
When we moved into the new house of Maybank back in July 2010, we set up the global wholesale banking model, among others, not only in Malaysia but also in Singapore and in Indonesia. And it is progressing very well. With that, we have been able to secure major mandates across the region. And this is on account of our enhanced ability to distribute equity products not only in this region but also in other financial centres like Hong Kong, London and New York.
The acquisition of Kim Eng. This is in line with our group's aspiration to be a regional financial powerhouse. Maybank Investment Bank now has a presence in 11 countries, human capital force of close to 4,000 people.
I would say that Kim Eng has a pretty strong branding within the region as it is right now. But with the Maybank group behind it, and if you combine the branding of the two, it even makes it a much, much stronger proposition.
Maybank have a people-centred philosophy in everything that we do in terms of career development. Maybank Singapore's transformation journey focuses on business excellence, a framework based on international best practices.
What are the key areas of growth, particularly not only in Malaysia, but the various pockets in ASEAN, be it our colleagues in Singapore, in Indonesia, how could the Islamic banking business contribute to that growth for the group? We want to be sure that we are the best Islamic bank.
Maybank has seen to improve a lot in the areas of global banking. They've moved from a typical corporate banking to a bank that supports Felda Global Group.
Our vision is to be the regional financial services leader by 2015. From a regionalization perspective, group finance needs to be able to support the entire group in moving towards regionalization. And we will then move it along three perspectives: organization, process and system.
To integrate the group risk management across the group more effectively, we operate across different geography, different countries. We want to make sure that when we manage our risks across the group.
Pengalaman saya selama 2 tahun di BI, saya melihat banyak involvement dari tempat kami, compliance kepada unit kerja, terutama pada saat inisiatif untuk produk atau aktivitas baru, mulai dari diskusi pertama kali sampai kemudian kami mengajukan proposal ke Bank Indonesia sampai kemudian disetujui.
Driving regional initiatives across ASEAN into Asia Pacific, we will have to be looking at things like centers of excellence that will enable us to leverage scarce skills and other talent, developing capabilities that will bring best practices from different countries to be shared among the other operating units within the Maybank Group.
The key to achieving productivity will be to mobilize and deploy our resources efficiently, and this includes providing Maybankers with the right tools, the right support, efficient systems and processes. Whilst we all work hard, there will also be plenty of opportunities for you to showcase your talents. It can be winning innovative ideas, your great sense of volunteerism, sporting, or even singing capabilities. It is important not only to enjoy the work you do, but to also have fun at work.
I like to work in Maybank. I will continue working in Maybank. Maybe in 3 years in time, I'll become an officer. And hopefully one day, I'll become the branch manager. I serve from my heart. Thank you.
In MTCC, we are very eager to embrace 2012 as we expect to see major changes in terms of products, process and systems as Maybank continues on our transformation journey.
There's one recent case where there's a major Middle East investor that's looking at investing in the Southeast Asian region, and they were looking at to transfer a significant amount of money into Malaysia. They approached two largest banks here in Malaysia. Our people went to meet with the client, tried to understand their needs, and as they walk out of the meeting room, they saw a team of six from the competitor banks, all well-suited and so on. The customer actually chose us simply because we humanize financial services. We came up with a solution for them, as opposed to trying to push a sophisticated product, which was actually the emphasis of the other competitor. This experience was shared to me by our regulator themselves. Our people, UMO Bank, will continue to embrace our mission of humanizing financial services and making sure that we apply such a mission in our daily lives. And this is where you will see immediate impact, and that will contribute towards sustainability.